All right, so what are we doing now, guys?
One final clean of the block and applying this.
A really thin layer of, what is that stuff? Anaerobic sealer. On the very edge of these two, very corner, back corner port, just a tiny, tiny thin layer to prevent leakage, because the block itself still has some, a little bit of pitting from the age. So put a tiny little bit there, just a really thin film, and a really thin film there where it's where the block has got a little tiny bit of pitting around the coolant ports to prevent leakage.
All right, let's get it.
This is why it takes extra time to build an engine sometimes. This thing here came, and these little sticky, they've got sticky all over the bottom of them. You see that sticky? These things were sitting on top of the head gasket like this. Apparently this box had gotten jarred, and now we got the sticky all over the fire rings, the sticky all over this. It's here, and the head gasket itself is scarred here where it has shifted. So now the drama continues. We get to try to find another head gasket. This one is, I wouldn't put this on my truck. So that kind of sucks, because we got the head suspended over the block, ready for the head gasket. So I guess that's all part of putting one together and why there's delays.
Cleaning all my head bolts. Gotta get them all nice and clean before we put them in.
All right, I oiled it up. I oiled up the bolt. Just wipe the excess oil off. Just pat it a little bit. You don't want so much oil that it's running down, because if you do, it'll run down in the hole and it'll create hydraulic pressure, because the air will get trapped in the bottom of the hole and it'll throw off the torque reading. It'll also won't hold as well. So you oil the threads, and then you just kind of dab off the excess oil a little bit. And then you need, what I do, is put a tiny little bit of assembly lube here, one little tiny half a drop, and run my finger around just enough to wet it. Not enough to really lube it, just enough to wet it so that it doesn't chatter against the, this surface doesn't chatter when I go to do the final torque. So now I got a little bit of just a thin film of assembly lube on there. So after I do that, I put it in the hole. I'm gonna start them all. I'm just gonna put them all in the hole and just, you know, just hit them really lightly, just to sort of run them down like this. That's it. And then just, I'm gonna get them all in there and do every one of the bolts. I'm not gonna start torquing them yet. Set this for 75. Let's set them all at 75, and then we'll go 150, and then we'll go 300. All right, let's see if we can follow this pattern. You tell me which one's next. You watch the pattern, and I'll tighten. That way we don't make mistakes. I'm not looking back and forth so damn much. Start right here in the center. That's number one. Yeah. That one? They're nowhere near that. They're nowhere near tight. We're just gonna start snugging them. I'm not gonna follow the pattern yet. I'm just gonna start them. all just slightly snug. All right, let's follow our pattern now. You want to grab that core, plug this camera in. All right, you tell me which one to do next, and I'll tighten, okay? All right. We're gonna go 75 first. All right, what's next? Next is 150, right?
Yep.
All right. Next we'll do 150.
Okay. Come on up here. Guide it. I'll target. Okay, I torqued all the head bolts to 300 foot-pounds. Now we're gonna wait overnight, 24 hours, I guess, roughly. And then we're gonna check them all again. We'll probably end up getting a quarter turn or more out of them again. Because overnight, the head gasket will finally crush and it'll seat everything. And all the torque will actually get less. So we'll have to re-torque it after waiting overnight. We go to lock it down now, it's final position, it'll probably be too loose. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna wait, let it sit overnight and torque it again.